The next presentation involves the intraoral radiography, methods of obtaining the pictures, and also the understanding of the difference between paralleling and bisecting angle techniques, which we'll cover in detail at this point. There are two basic techniques for obtaining periapical radiographs in dentistry. One is called the paralleling technique. The other is called the bisecting angle technique. The American Academy of Oral and Maxillofacial Radiology and the American Association of Dental Schools recommend very strongly the use of the paralleling technique because it gives the most accurate image. At times, however, you will not be able to take the paralleling technique because of anatomic deviations in some patients' mouths that will not allow you to place the XCP holder appropriately in there, and then the bisecting angle technique can be utilized, but it is always a compromise in the integrity of the picture itself. The full mouth X-ray survey, as I mentioned previously in another chapter, requires, in most dental offices, 18 pictures. This can be 16, 14, 18, depending on the office's definition. But generally, there are 14 periapicals and 4 to 6 bite wings, but the number can vary. And the X-rays must be mounted appropriately so that when the doctor comes to interpret the X-rays, the films are placed in their right position on the holder or on the digital sensor. Film placement is the most critical portion of taking the X-ray from the standpoint of technique. Position the film parallel to the long axis of the tooth. The film in the film holder must be placed away from the teeth and toward the middle of the mouth. Vertical angulation. Direct the central ray of the X-ray beam perpendicular to the film and the long axis of the tooth. Horizontal angulation directs the central ray beam through the contact areas between the teeth. And the central ray on the film ensures that all areas of the film are being exposed. The paralleling technique will be shown in the following slides. And the film position is placed parallel to the long axis of the tooth. The film in the film holder must be placed away from the teeth and toward the middle of the mouth. This deviation is called a cone cut, and in this situation, the film or the sensor has not been bisected by the ray of the X-ray machine, and part of the film has not been exposed to radiation. When exposing radiographs, establish an exposure sequence or a definite order for periapical film placement. Without a proper sequence, there is a good chance that you will omit areas or expose the same area twice. When exposing periapical films with the paralleling technique, always start with the anterior teeth first, canines and incisors, because the number one size film used for anterior is small and less uncomfortable and easier for the patient to tolerate. It is easier for the patient to become accustomed to the anterior film holder, and the anterior film placements are less likely to cause the patient to gag. However, many offices do not use size 1 film. They use the size 2 film routinely for all X-rays, and then in that case, whether you expose in the anterior region first or the posterior is really operator choice. The exposure sequence: begin with the maxillary right canine, expose all of the maxillary anterior teeth, end with the maxillary left canine, and then move to the mandibular arch. Expose the mandibular arch the same as the maxillary arch, and finish that with the mandibular right canine tooth. after completing the anterior teeth, begin the posterior teeth. Always expose the premolar film before the molar film because the placement is easier for the patient to tolerate than the molar film. And you want to make sure that the premolars, both of them, the first and second premolars, are always covered in the film. It's a common error in that the film is placed too far distally in the mouth so that the first premolar, which is in a very critical area of the mouth, is sometimes shortchanged. You want to cover the distal of the canine with the film or the sensor before placing taking the x-ray film to make sure that the first bicuspid or premolar is always included in the survey. Tips for film placement. The white side of the film always faces the teeth. The anterior films are always placed vertically, and the posterior teeth, the films are always placed horizontally. The identification dot on film is always placed in the slot of the film holder. The expression is called dot in the slot, and that orients the film to the biting surface of the teeth that are being taken. Always position the film holder away from the teeth and toward the middle of the mouth. Always center the film over the areas to be examined, and always place the film parallel to the long axis of the teeth. Preparation before seeing the patients. Prepare the operatory with all your infection control barriers. Label a paper cup if you're using film with the patient's name and the date, because frequent mistake is to not label the x-ray film, and when you come back to it later, identifying the film for that patient can be very, very difficult to ascertain. So labeling is always a critical issue when using film. Position the patient comfortably in the dental chair with the back in an upright position and the head supported properly. Ask the patient to remove their eyeglasses and any bulky earrings. Have the patient remove any removable prosthesis that would affect the quality of the picture. And position the patient with the occlusal plane of the jaw being radiographed parallel to the floor when the mouth is in the open position. Always drape the patient with a lead apron and a thyroid collar, and wash and dry your hands and put on clean examination gloves before proceeding. The following slides will be presented but not demonstrated until you reach the clinic, where each tooth and each radiographic procedure will be explained and demonstrated. The bisecting angle technique infers that the bisection of the angle technique is based on a geometric principle of bisecting a triangle. Bisecting means dividing into two equal parts. The angle formed by the long axis of the teeth and the film is bisected, and the x-ray beam is directed perpendicular to that bisecting line. Perpendicular means at a right angle to the film. Film holders must always be used, as we mentioned before, using the patient's fingers, as was common practice up until the 1970s, is never recommended and is not accepted at this point. In the bisecting technique, the angulation of the PID is critical. Angulation is the term used to describe the alignment of the central ray of the x-ray beam in the horizontal and vertical planes. Angulation can be changed by moving the PID in either a horizontal or vertical direction. The bisecting angle instruments with aiming rings dictate the proper PID alignment. Horizontal angulation refers to the positioning of the tube head and direction of the central ray in a horizontal or side-to-side plane. The horizontal angulation remains the same whether you're using paralleling or bisecting techniques. With correct horizontal angulation, the central ray is directed perpendicular to the curvature of the arch and through the contact areas of the teeth. Incorrect horizontal angulation results in overlapping or unopened contact areas. A film with overlapping contact area cannot be used to examine and diagnose interproximal caries or disease. This is the appropriate position of the X-ray beam to go through each contact appropriately. Incorrect horizontal angulation, as defined by this slide, gives you a picture where the contacts between the posterior teeth are overlapped and are non-diagnostic between them and must be retaken. Vertical angulation refers to the positioning of the PID in a vertical or an up and down plane. The vertical angulation differs according to the radiographic techniques being used. With the paralleling technique, the vertical angulation or central ray is directed perpendicular to the film and the long axis of the tooth. With the bisecting technique, the vertical angulation is determined by the imaginary bisector. The central ray is directed perpendicular to the imaginary bisected angle. Correct vertical angulation results in a radiographic image that is the same length as the tooth is in the mouth. Incorrect vertical angulation results in an image that is not the same length, and it can be either elongated or foreshortened. In the bisecting technique, the film is placed close to the crowns of the teeth as possible and extends at an angle to the palate or the roof of the mouth. The film package should extend beyond the incisal edge or the occlusal aspect of the teeth by about 1/8 to 1/4 inch. That pertains as well for the digital sensor as it does for film. Film holders for the bisecting angle technique include some with alignment indicators and are available commercially. The X-ray beam is directed to pass between the contacts of the teeth being radiographed in the horizontal dimension, just as it does in the paralleling technique. The vertical angle, however, must be directed at 90 degrees to the imaginary bisecting line in order to give you an X-ray that is as close to the appropriate angulation as possible. The occlusal technique is used to examine large areas of the upper or lower jaw. In the occlusal technique, size 4 intraoral film is used. This film is so named because the patient bites or occludes on the entire film, not using any holder to take this. In adults, size 4 is used in the occlusal examination. In children, it can be a size 2 film placed in the same relative position. The film is positioned with the white side facing the arch being exposed, and the film is placed in the mouth between the occlusal surfaces of the maxillary and mandibular teeth. The film is stabilized when the patient gently bites into the film, not distorting the placement. Patients with special needs. Radiographic examination techniques must often be modified to accommodate patients with special needs. The dental radiographer must be competent in altering the techniques to meet the specific diagnostic needs of that individual patient. Patients with disabilities, wheelchair bound, etc., need to be accommodated effectively and can usually be placed in appropriate positions without transferring them to the dental chair. even patients who are edentulous must be, a full set of pictures need to be taken, because we detect the presence of root tips, impacted teeth and lesions, cysts, tumors, etc., and to identify objects which are embedded in the bone. So even though the patient may present with no teeth apparent in their mouth, a set of pictures of one sort or the other need to be taken. This is one area where the panoramic or the external x-ray film is most effective. Radiographs for the pediatric patient. In children, x-rays are useful for detecting conditions of the teeth and bones, for showing changes related to caries or decay and trauma, and for evaluating growth and development. Explain the radiographic procedures you're going to take on that patient and to the child and to their parent so that they understand it and are not unnecessarily upset or anxious about the procedure. Everything else follows the same procedures as we would for adults. As I mentioned before, sometimes you can't use the XCP holder because it's larger than some children can affect, and in that case you would use the bisecting tank technique with the appropriate holders for that patient. The patient who gags, we still need to get pictures, so sometimes we'll use the extraoral film instead of the intraoral film, and their palates can be sprayed with appropriate medications to eliminate the gag reflex for a short period of time. To correctly mount the dental x-rays, the dental system must be able to recognize the normal anatomic landmarks on intraoral pictures. These include the median palatine suture, the incisive foramen, the anterior nasal spine, the nasal septum, and the nasal fossa. Landmarks on the mandible include the genial tubercles, lingual foramen, nutrient canals, mylohyoid ridge, external oblique ridge, and the medial and the mental ridge. Handle film if you're using film only by the edges. Label and date the film immediately before processing, and then certainly as you're mounting the films into the mounter, make sure the patient's name and the date that they were taken are placed on the mounting holder before you place any films into it. And use clean and dry hands. Any powder on your hands while handling film can contaminate and ruin the picture image.